Racnoss Empress of the Racnoss.
Welcome back to Doctor Who Makeup. As you can probably tell from that intro, I'm going to be recreating the Racnoss Empress today. This will be the first special effects tutorial from Series 3. Technically, it's a Christmas special, but I'm considering it Series 3. This is going to be a really long tutorial, so I apologize in advance. This is because there's a lot of steps to this tutorial, and it took me multiple days to put together for you. I really like the way that it turned out, and I hope you do too. So, let's get started. I'm going to be starting off by putting on a bald cap. This one's from the dollar store, and what it's going to do is it's going to keep all of our little hairs and flyaways from escaping from out of the headpiece. For this, you're going to want to apply it with spirit gum and or liquid latex, just to make sure that all the edges stay completely down. You won't see it once we start putting on the actual face paint. Next, I'm going to be taking some liquid latex and just applying it around the edges and the seams of the bald cap, just to make sure that everything blends in and to make it look very seamless. Before you move on, make sure that this layer completely dries, because you do not want it to be sticky or tacky when you go to put on your headpiece. You're going to want to glue down your eyebrows for this look. Probably should have done that before I put on the bald cap, but it's a little bit too late for that. So for this, I'm just using a glue stick that I found around my house. It's non-toxic, so it's safe for your skin. And if you need to blend it in with anything, what I suggest is you steal a little spoolie from Sephora and blend it in with that. So I waited for the glue stick to dry, and afterwards I put a little bit of liquid latex on it just to make sure that everything was set and it was pretty smooth. Then I let that dry. I quickly dried it with the hair dryer, and then because it was a little bit tacky, I just put some baby powder over top because I do not want my eyebrows to be tacky. And now it's time for face paint. I'm going to be using these cheap $1 ones from Walmart that I got last Halloween, and they're pretty great because they're inexpensive and they work for what I need. So I have some red, some orange, some white, some black, and some brown, and I'm going to start off with the red and apply an even base all over my face as well as along my neck. Wherever your skin is going to be exposed, that's where you want to put the face paint. If you're wearing the full-on costume, which would be super awesome by the way, you want to make sure that it goes a little bit lower than where the costume sits. That way everything blends in perfectly. For this step, I'm going to be blending everything on a paper plate. I already have my red on here, and I'm just going to be blending everything on this. That way after the tutorial's done, I can just throw out the plate and I'm not ruining anything. To apply the face paint, I'm just going to be using whatever kind of brush you want. This one is a flat eyeshadow one that I got from my cousin who didn't like it, and honestly I don't like it as an eyeshadow brush either, so I'm just using it for face paint, and I've used this in other tutorials that have special effects themed looks as well. Next, we're going to be putting on some highlight, or at least lighting the high points of the face. So for this, we're going to be using the orange and potentially the white if the orange isn't enough. Afterwards, we are going to be putting on the shadows, which for this, we're going to be using the black and the brown, which are the colors that I use to mix for the shadows for the matching headpiece. And all of the colors that I'm using match pretty much exactly to the colors that I used on the headpiece. And we just want to make sure that we get everything looking as similar as possible. And then once we put on the headpiece, we can always fix up anything that might not look exactly right. So for now, let's start with the highlight. I'm going to be taking a smaller brush for this. This is a Forever 21 eyeshadow brush. The reason that I left my eyes and my lips completely clear of any of the red makeup is because she doesn't really have a lot of red makeup on both her eyelids and her lips. She has black lipstick and black eyes. So I'm going to be using two different products. I'm not going to be applying the lips right now. I'm going to wait till later. But for the eyes, I'm going to be going in with the Maybelline Color Tattoo in, what is this, Dramatic Black. It's the matte black that I use for everything. And I'm going to be using my finger to apply this. But if you want more precise lines, use a brush. So something similar to the one that I just used for the highlight. Thank you. worry, this is just the base for now. I'm going to be applying more shadows and highlights and all of the beautiful things over top of this to blend it in a lot better. So now I'm going to be taking the brown and taking a cosmetic sponge, just like a cheap one that you can find at the store, and I'm going to be applying the shadows with the sponge. You will see when I put together the head and I add in all the different shadows, I'm using the exact same technique, but I'm using the small end. For this, I'm just going to be using just kind of whatever, just to make sure that it looks good. Now I'm going to go back into the white because the orange is kind of lost on my face. So for this, I'm just going to be applying it over top of where I put the orange already, wait till it dries a little bit, and then go back in with the orange over top just to brighten it up a little bit. Now I'm going to start putting on the black dots with the black cream makeup, and I'm going to alternate through a variety of different brushes. I think I'm going to start off with the Soho brush to get some of the larger dots, and then as they get smaller, I will decrease in brush size. Majority of your face makeup is on, you might have to adjust it later once you put on your headpiece, just because some of the colors might be off, and I know mine will be just a little bit. I think my face is a bit too red and a bit too orange, so I will have to apply more later, but for now we're just gonna go ahead with the rest of the tutorial. So the Empress has some really nice fake teeth, and so do I. However, I've used up all of the putty for them, so I can't put them on, plus they're really difficult to wear. So for this look, I'm going to be skipping them, but if you have a set of fake teeth that look like vampires, I would definitely recommend using it if you're going for a more realistic look with this tutorial. Next, what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be lining my eyes and I'm going to be applying my lipstick. Those are the last two things that you want to do before you put on your headpiece. So I'm going to start by lining my eyes. This is the Essence Gel Liner in Black Blaze. And now for lips. I have two options for you. The one is a black lipstick. This is the Wet n Wild Fantasy Makers lipstick in black. It came out like last year or 2 years ago. Essentially any black lipstick will work. Or the NYX Jumbo Eye Pencil in Black Bean. I think I'm going to use this because it's a little bit more pigmented, but if you want more of a glossy look and something that's actually wearable on your lips, I would definitely recommend a black lipstick. And that is it for makeup. Now it's on to building the headpiece. This is my finished product. I think it looks really great. So, I'll give you a 360 of it. It looks super cool. Not exactly how she has it, but for something that's homemade DIY, I think it turned out really great. So I started by building a model out of Bristol board. I used about two pieces of Bristol board for this because I wanted to make the headpiece as light as possible and I wanted to make it hollow. I started by making seven different cones. The giant one is the one that you want to make sure is measured to your head and make it a little bit bigger because the next few steps will make it a little bit smaller. Make it a little bit bigger, round it out, make it a cone shape, and if you need to cut it like I did, cut it into strips and then individually put them into place to make a giant cone. You don't need it to be super pointed at the end because in the next step I will show you how to get it super pointed. The other cones that you're going to be using, you want to make sure that they are the perfect length and you want to make sure that they match on either side so it's perfectly symmetrical. The two cones in the front, you want to make sure that they're on the same diagonal as the big cone. So when you cut the base of them, cut them on a diagonal so that way they sit flush to the giant cone. That way they're on the same angle. The ones along the sides, you just want to make sure that they look good, and when you put it on your head, which you might want to for reference, you want to make sure that you can see them and they stick out the side. The two cones at the back are going to be the smallest, and it doesn't really matter how big you make them, just make sure that they stick out and you can definitely tell that they are sticking out when you turn to the side and you can see them through your profile. I use tape to put everything together. You want to make sure that you have a very strong hold tape. Don't use the cheap stuff for this because you want to make sure that those cones and the Bristol board will stay in place. The second step for this headpiece is to put expanding foam on top of your Bristol board shell. I have a styrofoam head, which is perfect for this because the headpiece fit on it perfectly, even though it's a little bit small. But if you don't, I recommend using something that's recyclable, that you are okay with getting dirty, something that you're okay with throwing out afterwards, maybe like a Pringles container or something that's tall and wide enough to hold your headpiece up. And if you need to tape it down, I would definitely recommend doing that because I had to do that. So what you want to do is you want to spray your expanding foam all over your headpiece, making sure you get in all the little nooks and crannies. And remember, it will expand, so don't put on too much, but just make sure that it's enough that it will cover everything and it will look good. You're gonna have to wait a while for this to dry completely. I waited overnight and then I began to carve it. So to carve it, I used two different knives that my dad told me I could use. So basically, I had a reference photo, which is the reference photo I've been following pretty much this entire tutorial, and I just carved the basic shape of the headpiece. Some areas I didn't put enough expanding foam, so I went back, put some more on, waited for a while, and then continued carving. You just want to make it look as close as possible. It's okay if there's going to be holes and gaps. We're going to fill that in a minute. Just make sure that it looks as similar to the original as possible. Now to cover in all of those cracks and holes, I applied a thin coat of watered down plaster. Now you don't have to do this if you don't want. I personally don't think I would do it again if I were to remake this. I just wanted something that would harden out the outside without ruining the inside. So I watered down some of the plaster and I just applied it with a thick paintbrush. Applied it all over, got in all the nooks and crannies, really evened everything out, and then I let it dry overnight. So now we are going to color this thing. I used a bright cherry red spray paint as the base because I knew I wanted it to be red right off the bat. I didn't want to start out with any of the blacks, so I spray painted the entire thing red, and I'm sorry I didn't get the shot of the plaster completely over top of this beforehand, but I wanted to test out the spray paint. So I spray painted it in two different coats, let it dry in between just to make sure that everything was evenly coated and it was nice and glossy and shiny. Then I went in with a black spray paint and I added all the shadows. So what I did for this was basically any part on the headpiece that you would think would have a shadow for when you view it face on, that's where I put black spray paint. I just made it look as real as possible. Of course, in different lights, you won't have a shadow in that exact spot, but I wanted to keep it as real looking as possible. So I added the shadows to the back of pretty much all of the horns and in and around any of the textured layering on the big horn. Once I was done with the spray paint, I brought it inside and I started to paint it with some acrylic paint. I started out with an orange acrylic paint because I wanted to add this color as the highlight rather than a white because it looked more realistic with the orange than with the white. So I applied this to all of the high points of the headpiece, basically following the reference photo to see where the light hit the high points on the headpiece as much as possible. And that is where I concentrated the color. I blended this in with a makeup sponge because I thought that it gave it more of an airbrush look, which it did. Then I went in and I added all of the spots with a black and a brown acrylic paint using a tiny little paintbrush. It's actually the paintbrush that I used to apply all the spots to my face, but I painted the headpiece first. Then I blended it out with a makeup sponge. This was to give it more of a hazy, less opaque look, and I really liked the way that it turned out. After I had finished putting on all of the different dots, I went back in with the black and the brown paint and the makeup sponge, and I added the shadows all over the headpiece. In some spots, the shadows were more black, and in some spots, the shadows were more brown. Once this was done, I decided to go in and add the eyeballs. Now, originally, I was just going to carve out the foam to make the eyeballs, but my dad suggested that I use something else for the eyes. So what we did was we found these eyeball ping pong balls at our local dollar store, and I ended up spray painting two of them black, and then I ended up not spray painting the other two because they were too sticky to work with, because the spray paint that I was using wasn't actually spray paint. But anyways, what I did was I cut them in half with some scissors and then I pinched them to make them look more of a ravioli shell kind of shape. And then I cut them a little bit more on either side just to give it more of like an indented look. And then I pushed it into the mask a little bit. Then I took scissors and I stamped out the exact location of where the eyeball, little ping pong ball, was going to sit. After that, I applied some hot glue in those creases and then I put the ping pong ball and I held it in place until it completely dried. I did this to all four of the eyeballs and I continued on with painting. Because there is a little bit of the hot glue, you're going to want to paint over that, so just apply a little bit more black over top of that. And for the two eyeballs that I didn't actually paint, I ended up painting them a matte black. After this, I went in with just the finishing touches, adding extra highlights, adding more dots all over the faces, and then I added darker black and brown to the tips of all the horns because that is what the original had. Once I was done painting it, I brought it back outside and I applied a sealer, which is basically a clear spray paint. It made it look nice and shiny, like a top coat of a nail polish, and I just really liked the way that it turned out. Now, before I did this tutorial, I tried on the headpiece and I realized that the expanding foam and the plaster kind of shrunk the original mold out of the Bristol board. So what I ended up doing was I had to cut it back a little bit and I had to rip out some of the Bristol board from inside and shave off some of the foam from inside the headpiece. That way it fit over my giant cranium, but nothing was ruined, and because the spray foam was everywhere, you're not going to be missing pieces and things won't fall out because it's really sticky and everything is stuck together. And so now we get to put on the beautiful headpiece. Okay, now as you can see, the head is very glossy. And I'm not as glossy, so if you want to put like an Evian spray, which is just a little bit of water, you totally can, but I'm really happy with the way that it turned out. So, we're just gonna make this transition a little bit easier. And there we go, this is the finished tutorial. I hope you enjoyed this Christmas special tutorial. I have one more look coming from this episode. That will be in 2 more days. I hope you enjoyed watching, and I will see you again next time. Bye.